Hey everybody, Dimi here, and this is how we can run Windows Virtual Machines on a Mac. What I have is a 2021 MacBook Pro M1, but this should work on newer Apple Silicon chips as well, M2, M3, and so on. Let's get into this. So first, let's download the Windows ARM 64 image. Just search for download Windows Insider ARM 64. I'll pick the first result, and here we see that we need to be a member of the Windows Insider program. It's not a big deal, just sign in with your Windows account, create one if you don't have it. And after signing in, I can accept the terms and register for the Insider program. Okay, start, and we're taken to a getting started page, but we want to go back to the Windows 11 on ARM download page, pick the dev build, and confirm. You're asked for the language. I don't know why there's only one to pick, but pick English, confirm. And finally, the download button. We see that we're downloading a VHDX file, which stands for Virtual Hard Disk Drive Extended, which is just a format for running virtual machines. Next off, we need to download Mac UTM. The first result is what we're after, download. And after it finishes, we just drag UTM to applications. Let's run it. Are you sure? Yes. Open. And here it is. UTM. Finally, let's create a VM. Pick virtualize. Windows. Pick VHDX. Make sure that the drivers and spice tools are checked. Find our Windows 11 VHDX. Open. Continue. For memory, we stay with 4 gigs. 2 CPU cores, just for the sake of it. Hit continue twice. And here we can give our VM a name. My Windows VM. And we hit save. Creating a VM takes a couple of seconds, and after that we can see that Windows guest support tools are being installed. I'll wait it out and run the Windows VM. This loading is gonna take a while, so I'll just speed up the video. And after it's done, we see the install wizard. Before doing anything, hit function shift F10, and this will bring up the command prompt, where we need to input the following command. OOBE/bypass NRO. This command bypasses the network requirements and makes it so we don't have to log in with a Microsoft account during installation. Hit enter and the VM will reboot, and we're back to the installation wizard. Now we can install it. Country US, keyboard US, skip. Here we say I don't have internet. Accept, name, password, confirm it, stupid security questions, type in whatever. And I'll toggle off all of these privacy features. We hit accept, and that's all. And after waiting for a while, we have Windows 11 on a Mac M1. Let's quickly do one more thing. Open the Explorer, go to this CD drive, and install the UTM guest tools. That is going to enable us to change the resolution of the virtual screen, and we're going to need to reboot to make the guest tools work. And there it is, Windows 11 on a Mac. Let's shut down the machine and I'll show you one more useful thing that I do all the time. I will make a clone of this VM. And I'm gonna name it My Windows VM Clean Installation. This way I can play with the upper one, and if I screw anything up, I can just delete it and clone the snapshot that I just made. And that's all. If this was useful to you, hit like, subscribe, and see you next time.